Hopefully you're all here interested in teaching. Can I just ask who's perhaps interested in secondary teaching? Primary, middle? Primary? Early childhood? Right, I'll be briefly talking about these various pathways into teaching. I guess just to set the scene, I want you to be assured that if you choose to study here at the University of South Australia, that you will be studying at a great university. As you're probably aware, we're a relatively new university since 1991, but we have progressed extremely positively and encouragingly over the last couple of years. And as you can just see from the data there, I'm not going to go through it, that we are an increasingly progressive, innovative university who are increasing our standings in the world rankings. Right, I guess you've come here because you are interested in teaching. But I guess I like to just challenge you with, you know, are you someone who enjoys working with young people? Are you passionate about learning? Are you a good communicator? Are you interested in making a difference to the lives of people? And I guess if that's the case, then teaching may be a career for you. The other area then to look at once you've decided that you want to be a teacher is, do you want to specialise in a particular area? Then maybe secondary teaching. If you want to teach across the various curricula, then maybe you should consider the early years or the primary in their early development. So you need to think about, what age would I enjoy working with young people? Okay, five programs that I'm just going to briefly talk about and give you opportunity to answer questions are the Master of Teaching. I'm assuming, even if perhaps at this stage you don't have a degree, but you are looking at either you've got a degree and want to come into teaching now, or you're looking in the future at attaining a degree and then coming into teaching. So I'm going to be talking about the early childhood, the junior primary, the primary middle, and middle secondary, and the one-year graduate diploma in education. The graduate diploma will be in its last year next year, and I'll speak a little bit more about that as we go through. Okay, just briefly, just to give you a quick rundown, the early childhood, if you're interested in early childhood, you're trained for childcare settings, for sessional preschool, and for junior primary schools. So in all of our degrees, we try to train you across a range, hopefully increasing your employment opportunities. You can see there, I won't go necessarily through all the statistics, but roughly 25 students are taken into that program, got the grade point average. It is a two-year full-time study program. And I guess the feature of this program is that you do placements both in childcare, in preschool or kindergarten, and in junior primary settings. And you can then choose upon graduation where you want to market yourself, etc. This program is offered at the McGill campus. The junior primary, again, prepares you in the junior years and in the primary years from 3 to 7, and you have the opportunity to work in government, Catholic and independent schools. About 60 places in this program, a 4.5 grade point average. Again, it's a two-year or full-time program, and that one is also offered at McGill. I'll go through these in a little bit more detail, but just giving you the rundown so that you can see what's being offered. The primary middle prepares you both for the primary, 3 to 7, and for the middle years, sometimes defined as 6 to 9, 6 to 10. It just depends. Schools vary a little bit. and generally you can teach up to year 10. It's a 2-year full-time program, but it can be accelerated to 18 months. So you just do all the courses, but in an accelerated mode. And graduates then are prepared to teach the full range of primary curriculum, as well as 2 specialist areas. And this program's offered at Mawson Lakes campus. The middle secondary, again, prepares you roughly for 6 to 9, and then for the senior years of 10 to 12, approximately 120. The reason why the quota is higher is because we don't have an undergraduate degree in this area, whereas we offer undergraduate degrees in the other specialised areas. And so the quota is higher. Grade point average, again, about the same, except arts education is very popular, and so the grade point average is usually around 5. Other specialisations are 4. Again, it's a 2-year program, but can be accelerated to 18 months, and it's offered also at Mawson Lakes. The graduate diploma, as I indicated, it will be phased out after next year. The reason being is because we have new accreditation requirements. The new national standards are requiring a 2-year teacher qualification. The graduate diploma is only 1 year. Now, for those people who decide to come into the graduate diploma, it's not a problem. The program is registered. You are eligible for teacher registration. It's just in a transitioning, phasing out period. And Adelaide University, who also offers the graduate diploma, are going through the same situation where they have to convert their 1-year program to a 2-year program. Even though I've talked about the primary, middle and middle secondary being accelerated, remember I said it is a 2-year program. So that meets accreditation requirements. This one we principally prepare you for secondary. It's a 1-year program and it's offered at Mawson Lakes. Just take note, if you are interested in the graduate diploma, it's primarily for people who are wanting a change in careers. We expect you to have had a couple of years in the workforce because you come in with life experiences, so we feel we can train you in 1 year, whereas other people have come straight through their studies, we'd like to work with you for 2 years to ensure that you are effective teachers. Just note, the graduate diploma is through Apply Online, not SATAC. So that's through the university. Okay, because they are master's degrees or postgraduate degrees, the entry requirements are a minimal 3-year bachelor degree. Some of you may come in with a 4-year because you've done engineering or some other degree that is a 4-year degree, but a minimum 3-year degree from a recognised higher education institution. For the primary and middle and secondary, there is an additional requirement in that we need to be able to identify that you have specialised in areas that are taught in schools. In the early childhood and junior primary, basically you can come in with any degree and have a passion for working with children, but in the primary, middle and middle secondary, you do need to be specialised in the areas in which you teach, because we assume that you have the background knowledge to teach in the secondary schools. Similarly, for the graduate diploma, you need to have that background. In the primary and middle, just to give you a little bit more detail, we look for 2 areas in which you have specialised with a minimum of 4 courses, 4 semester length courses in those areas. For example, if you wanted to be in the middle years an English teacher specialist, you need to have studied 4 English courses, preferably a mix of language and literature, because they're both taught. You know, if you wanted to be a history teacher, you'd need 4 history courses, science, 4 science courses. With middle and secondary, what we look for is we look for a major teaching area that you can teach from years 8 to 12. And for that, you need a minimum of 6 semester length courses in that specialised area. So I guess it's a matter of thinking about what do we teach in schools? So what areas, what subjects would I need to prepare me for teaching in the secondary school? And so if you're wishing to teach to year 12, we expect that you've done at least 1 or 2 subjects at a third level. So for example, you know, if you wanted to be a biology teacher, you would have done some biology courses in your third year of your science degree. And similarly with English, 2 English courses, 2 maths courses. It's also ideal if you can have a minor learning area, and the minor then is 4 semesters, which will enable you to teach to year 10. It does give you the advantage of improving your employment options. However, if you come in and only have a major, we do also offer a number of courses that give you a special edge, such as Catholic Studies, if people wanted to teach in the Catholic education, or English as a second language. You don't have to have any prerequisites for that, so you may be interested in perhaps working with children, refugees, immigrants, international students, and VET vocational education training, which allows you to perhaps take on a coordinator role. These are the main learning areas that you need to, if you're looking at coming into teaching, arts education, English, maths, science, health and PE. Now, it still is called Studies of Society and Environment, but I'm assuming many of you are aware of the changes that are taking place in the education system with the national curriculum. So in 2013, when we were due to start teaching the national curriculum, and I'm not sure that South Australia's necessarily decided they will delay it or will go ahead or join New South Wales, but Studies of Society and Environment will be called Humanities and Social Sciences in future years. And the focus based on the national curriculum will be history and geography. So we are specifically looking at people in history and geography. Previously, the Studies of Society and Environment incorporated lots of courses around the society, citizenship. It also includes things like economics, politics, legal studies. We still take those into that, but it's a little unclear as to what's going to happen with the national curriculum. It's likely to be addressed in the third phase, but at the moment, when we've met with the Department of Education, who are our major employers, they're asking us now to have a focus on history and geography. So I'm advising people perhaps who are economists, done law, that they also think about combining that with, say, 4 histories or 4 geographies, because things like legal studies, economics, is only taught in year 11 and 12, which gives you very narrow opportunities. And if you've been following the paper too, you would have realised that with the new SACE and the requirements only of 4 courses in year 12, unfortunately, some of those areas have been the ones that have suffered at the moment. We expect things will settle down and the options will broaden a little bit. Languages other than English, well, they include the national curriculum is focusing on 9 languages, 4 Asian and 5 European, and they include things like Chinese, Japanese, Indonesian, Italian, German, French, Spanish. I'm not sure what the last one is, but... Pardon?
Polish.
Okay. Okay, currently our courses all require some on-campus attendance. More and more is going online, and there is a direction in the school that possibly 2013-2014, there will be many of our courses that will be totally available online, and others that may be in a blended mode, some attendance and some online work. You can take all of them part-time, so there's no requirement to do a full-time. The professional experience, which is the school placements, do require that you attend full-time. So when you do your professional experience, if you're working combined with work, you'll have to negotiate to be available full-time. What we mean by full-time is roughly 8:30 to 4:30 every day while you're on your placement. As I mentioned before, primary, middle and secondary in accelerated modes, whereas the early years and the junior primary remain require 2 years. Every student who comes into teaching is required to do a criminal history screening. So when you accept an offer into, whether it's an undergraduate or a postgraduate master's, it's advisable to immediately check the details on your letter of offer about applying for a criminal history screening. And that is currently not done through as a national police criminal through the national police. It's done through the Department of Family Services. So make sure that you do that particular police check rather than the national police check. They deal with it, and it is a national check, but slightly different. You may be wondering, well, what am I up for? Should I come into any of these programs? Roughly 4 courses. Each course requires 2 to 3 hours contact time. And so you're looking at somewhere between 12 and 15 hours of contact. As I said, that'll probably be somewhat reduced as more and more becomes available online. The accelerated version usually means you're doing 5 courses. A semester, or as we call it here at UniSA, a study period, and so your contact time is a little more. Of course, outside of that, we do expect study, and I've mentioned the full-time commitment. The structure of our programs basically consists of 3 components. You've got your curriculum, pedagogical studies. So, for example, if you're coming into primary, junior primary, the early childhood, you need to do some studies around the primary, what's taught in primary schools, your maths, your history, your science, your health and PE, those sorts of areas. Whereas in the primary, in the middle and the secondary, we focus more on the pedagogy because we're assuming that you've got the content knowledge. As I mentioned, you can come in with any degree into the early childhood and primary, which means we can't assume that you've got the various background in those curriculum areas taught in the primary. The professional experience. In the postgraduate, you are required to do somewhere our programs are between about 60 and 65 days of professional experience. Undergraduates, the requirement is at least 80 days. And then we also have education studies, which includes courses in psychology, understanding the curriculum, etc. And I'll just elaborate a little bit more on those. Here are some of the courses in the education studies that sort of gives you a broader understanding of education and better prepares you to work within the various groups. Now, you don't necessarily in the programs do all of those. I've taken, I guess, identified the courses across all of those 5 programs that I've talked about that could be in your various programs. Of course, people who are doing primary wouldn't be doing rethinking the middle years because they're not looking at a middle years focus. So there's some of the education studies. We also include in our studies about Indigenous education because, as we know, that's a concern within our mainstream classrooms. And you'll see we have courses in diverse student needs because of the diversity that exists within our classrooms, not only in gifted and those perhaps who have mental or physical disabilities, but we also have cultural differences and many other diversities within our classroom. And courses like Educators Work, understanding what it means to be in the profession. The professional experience placements, just to give you a rough idea of what's expected in each of the placements. Our first placement is usually in the junior primary, primary and middle secondary, 10 to 12 days, where it's not just purely observation. You are expected to do some teaching during that time, but it's a time to set the scene and give you an appreciation of the overall learning environment in which you will be working. Semester 2, or as UniSA we call it study period 5, there's approximately a 5-week professional experience. In many of those, that may consist of 5 introductory days so that you can familiarise yourself with the school. You might start teaching even during those introductory days, and then a 4-week block where you need to be there every day. It does vary a little across the programs. So overall, though, it's about a 5-week experience. And then because it's a 2-year program, you'll find that in your second year, you will then do the larger placement of 5 to 6 weeks of professional experience. With the early childhood, because you're also prepared for the pre-sesh childcare and also pre-sessional preschool, you do places in those. So you actually do 4 professional experiences. The grad dip, being only a 1-year program, there is opportunity for 2 professional experience placements. If anyone's got any questions, don't hesitate to ask. I guess our graduates, we prepare you to work as skilled and professional educators and to begin your career in at least 2 education settings. So although it may sound a little more complex, we're trying to increase your opportunities within the program. Okay. Any questions? Yes. You do them in different schools. We try to give you as broad an experience as possible. Just one thing I did forget, with the middle secondary, we do take a mid-year intake as well, whereas the other programs at the moment have only got a beginning of year intake. Unfortunately, if you do come in mid-year, you can't accelerate because of the placement of the pracs. They're always one in the beginning of the year, the next one and the following one, and so things have to be done sequentially. But I guess by having a mid-year intake, it does enable people to spread their load a little bit more, and particularly if your studies finish at the middle of the year, it gives you an opportunity to at least do some study while you combine it with work as well. Yes? That's still being decided. I guess if we sort of look at a bit of the trend around Australia, more courses are becoming totally available online. As you would know, that Charles Darwin offer their teacher education totally online, as do Charles Sturt, some of them, Deakin. I think for a while it will be optional. Yes? We have a professional experience office who does do the placements, but we ask you to fill out a form and ask for your specified areas in which you would like to do your placement. We don't ask for specific schools because it becomes difficult. It depends. When we contact the school, we ask them what they can offer. And They may offer us placements, but, well, I'm talking secondary now, for example. If you're a maths teacher, they may not offer in that particular school a maths placement. They may be willing to offer science and history. So we ask you where you would like to do your placement, what areas, north, south, east or west. We also ask you if there are any schools for which you are ineligible, and we ask you to identify schools that are ineligible as schools at which perhaps you did your own schooling, particularly for the bachelor's degree. If you've only just left the school the year before, we don't like to send you back there again. Also, if you've got family members there, we don't want to put students in compromising positions. So we ask you to eliminate those and go elsewhere. There is no requirement for a country placement, but you can choose to do a country placement. Yes? Look, we try to accommodate you in placing you somewhere nearby your home, but unfortunately it's not always possible just because the current climate is very difficult, particularly because schools have just become such busy places that, you know, we can't always guarantee, but we do try to do our best from that perspective. And I guess it might mean that you have your children in after-school hours care for those few weeks too. But the requirement is we are preparing you to be full-time teachers, and therefore the expectation is, as adjunct teaching staff, that's what you are, we prefer to call you pre-service adjunct staff rather than student teachers, is that, you know, you present yourselves in the capacity of being a staff member. If that's helped at all.
I was just wondering, when you take foundation studies, how does that work with the entry requirements into like primary and next year, or would there be a different process?
Now, I'm not totally familiar with the foundation studies, but you should be able to ask if you go to the education booth. So you're doing foundation studies now. So what have you done beforehand?
Childcare.
There, you certainly can. I know into childcare, they do have a pathway through that. So if you go to the education booth, talk to them about it. Anyone else got any other questions? Yes? No, it's on the degree that you've completed. The degree you use as your eligibility to come in. Look, it is flexible, and as you know with the, well, it was the TER, but now ATAR, you know, it does go up and down each year. So, you know, I would encourage you to apply, even if you're concerned that your GPA is a little bit lower. There may be other things that you can identify as reasons why you can cope with your studies. Because we all know that, you know, sometimes it takes in your first degree, you think, oh, well, yeah, this has changed from year 12 and it takes a little bit of time to settle down, and so perhaps your grades aren't as high as you perhaps should have aspired to. Yeah? Sorry? When you start the degree to when you... No, there isn't actually. So, no, it doesn't matter when you did your 10 years. We have many of 10 years, 20 years. The requirement is is your undergraduate degree, basically. Yeah. If you want secondary, you have to have specialised in the areas in which you wish to teach. If you find, and I've been advising many students recently, if you find that some of the courses, you know, you're passionate about teaching English, but you perhaps haven't got quite enough courses in that area, look at the Open University, because it does provide you with an opportunity to pick up discrete courses, and they then count towards the number of courses that you need to have as a major. Difficultly, with difficulty. I would look at perhaps supplementing that with history. And so, you know, you can enrol certainly in another degree, you know, one of our Bachelor of Arts, and pick up history. But if you're just looking for a couple of courses to do it through the university, and perhaps I shouldn't be quite saying this, you know, it can be expensive doing it as non-award. We are members of the Open University, the University of South Australia, and so that is another way of just picking up a few courses to give you that eligibility. Any other questions? Oh, I went through that really quickly. Usually I've got... am I going over time? Well, I hope... Yes? No, because schools are on holidays. Oh, you mean university holidays? Usually our placements are during the normal teaching semester, but the first one, for example, in the Master of Teaching in secondary is the last week of the teaching and the first week of swap vac. So it's sort of worked around that. So... And of course, it has to be when schools are operating, not when they're on holidays. Yeah?
How long is a semester?
13 weeks is the teaching, but you will find all of yours in the Master of Teaching is cut short because of the placements. So, for example, the first one is usually 11 or 12 weeks, the next one is about 9, and your last one is only 6, because then you go out and do your placements. So. Oh, yes. Here's contact details. Or, yeah. So if you want to copy those down or go on the uni website, I'm happy to receive emails. I do Ruth Gear. So if you go to the Master of Teaching Middle Secondary or the Graduate Diploma, you'll see my name there, and I'm willing to take emails. Even if it's about junior primary or... primary, middle, I can forward it on to the relevant person. You can see the various program directors there, so look up their addresses on the UniSA site.
If we're doing our placement, will we be also expected to continue doing other coursework, like assignments?
No, we usually try to have most of them out of the way, except some of your assignments may be related to what you've taught. So it might be a reflection on some of your teaching or presenting units of work that you have done in your teaching. So we try to allow you to focus purely on your placement, because we realise that it is a very important time and also a very stressful time. And you've got a lot of preparation, because in your last one you're basically operating as a full-time teacher. So we try to clear all the assignments before then. There are undergraduate programs for early childhood, for the junior primary, and the primary middle, not for secondary. And they're 4-year Bachelor of Education. So, you know, I guess this was a graduate pathway, so I didn't talk much about the undergraduate, but, so, you know, you've got the option of choosing one of those to qualify you in 4 years, or doing an undergraduate degree, and either taking 2 years or 18 months to get your next qualification. Okay. Well, thank you everyone for your attendance, and enjoy your day.